hello one and all, and welcome back to Ratchet and Clank Going Commando. My name is Josh Jepson. Today we are on the Thug HQ. Okay, before we do that, let me look and see if there's anything new. No, okay, so we're still back here with all this stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and maybe get the shield charger. I think there's another armor upgrade on this planet, though, so I'm not entirely sure. Shield charger, I usually get the shield charger on this planet, but anyway, here we go. Look, it even uses it for us, just to be cool, man. The shield charger. So obviously it does exactly what it says it does. It makes a shield. I believe when we upgrade the shield, it actually also shocks enemies that are around us, which isn't super useful, but it is slightly more useful than the way it starts, which is just basically a shield. But that's effective. It's effective, man, because you can use any other item you want. It's kind of like, because like pairing it with the synthanoids and another weapon makes you just pretty much kind of a god in a way, a god Lombax, which is exciting. Okay, so there's actually, there's a nanotech upgrade, and I can never remember how to pick this one up. I'm pretty sure you just have to swing and jump and hope that you make it. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Ta-da! And now we're starting line two of our nanotech upgrade quest. So that's exciting. We're actually getting pretty close to the end of the game, I believe. So this is a big level for me. This is one of the most memorable levels in the game for me. So I'm excited for this one. We can go that way. What's over here? Oh, it's a preview of things to come. Ooh, creepy. There's some tanks or something over there. And some vines. Look, there's vines. We can climb the vines. But no, we can't climb the vines. Instead, we will use that. The swingshot targets that pull stuff towards you are very rarely used in this game. Which is weird, because like that's new, right? You'd think that they would find some sort of cool puzzle use for it, but they didn't. I think it would have been interesting if they did some sort of thing where you had to pull like a flat. Oh! Oh, man. Okay, hang on. Gadgets. Dynamo. Yes, got it. Okay. I don't know what that does, but I'm pretty sure I need to hit the dynamo targets. So. Oh, actually, no, never mind. Oh, never mind. We're going to be able to hit them here, so I don't know what I was doing. This is all platforms for this segment. And I already activated one of them, so now we've got weird timing. That's okay. It actually worked out. It actually worked out really, really well. This is one of the coolest planets, with one of the most tedious and oh god, get out of my life. Well, I've got a shield on, so what do I care? See you later, fellas. No more helicopters? That seems like a weird weapon to try and kill me with. Just four helicopters going at me. And their helicopter blades. That's like a terrifying thing to me. Is being chopped up by being chopped up by, I said teleporter because I thought this was a teleporter. I'm like, no, it's not a teleporter. Ooh, okay, so actually there's the platinum bolt is up this way. Oh, yeah, there is armor. Man, I should have waited. No, never mind. I wouldn't have even remotely had enough. Anyway, electrosteel. We'll come back for that one a little bit later. But actually, over here is a little bit of a jumping puzzle in order to get our platinum bolt. There's only one platinum bolt on this planet, thankfully. This actually isn't that big of a planet, but for me, it's one of the planets that's the most memorable. You know what I mean? For like when I think of the... Oh, jeez, what? Oh, okay, I see now. I understand. Do-do-do-do-do. Oh my god, how did I even survive that? More side-scrolling, more crazy side-scrolling action. Oh! Doesn't last long, does it? Oh my god, I got stuck on the thing! No, don't get stuck on the thing! Don't get stuck on your... Oh god, Ratchet, come on, buddy. Ratchet, buddy, man! Come on, buddy! Don't get stuck on stuff. Don't get stuck on things! There. Platinum Bolt is mine. We actually, I think there's a total of 40 Platinum Bolts in the game, and I wonder if there's a way to let me see how many, Platinum Bolts I have. Yeah, I found 31. Wait a minute. Used 21. Oh, that's how many I have left. Okay, I'm like, there's not 9 left. There's 10 left if there's 40. So yeah, there's only 10 more platinum bolts to collect in the game. So we're already, you know, 75% of the way there. Now I've got to figure out how to get back. Oh, please make it. Oh, please make it. Oh, God, please make it. Now, one playthrough I did of this game, I don't remember if it was challenge mode playthrough or if it was the first playthrough. I'm pretty sure it was the first playthrough through. I actually played with, like, minimal weapons so that I would have enough bolts to buy the Zodiac at this point. The Zodiac is this gun here, which is 1.5 million bolts. And I remember, I just remember very distinctly coming out on this bridge and just destroying everybody with the Zodiac. Because it's an awful lot like the Rhino, in that it's like a really ridiculously overpowered weapon, which is why it's so expensive. And it's not generally a weapon that you would want to, you would be able to get on your first playthrough. It's just really unique they have another weapon like that, because they also have the Rhino 2, which is obviously the Rhino. Oh, nanotech all over your face! Beautiful. Beautiful nanotech for your face! This is a great place to upgrade your weapons to. This is one thing that I usually do. When I play through this segment of the game is I generally kill myself over and over and over again until I've upgraded my weapons more. At least for the mini rocket tube or whatever. But I'm not gonna do that, obviously, because we're doing a let's play here and I don't like to sit here for hours grinding my weapons. But I do that sometimes when I play through this game. So hopefully I won't have too much Oh my god, I love this gun. Freaking plasma coil is so good for this segment because of all the dudes. Look at all the dudes being shocked by the plasma coil. Oh god, you don't even know what's coming, man. You don't even know what's coming. All right, hang on. Let me go to my quick select. I want to put my shield charger on here somewhere. I haven't been using the bouncer. I'm not upgrading the bouncer right now. I'm actually trying to upgrade 3 weapons at once now because I've got the shield charger and I'm trying to upgrade that. And I'm also going to try to upgrade the synthenoid and the mini rocket tube. But while the mini rocket tube is out of ammo, I'm going to try and upgrade the plasma coil. So it's like, yeah, I got a lot going for me. The plasma coil is going to be very useful on an upcoming planet. Here, look. I don't want to be in my shield. Oh my god. Die, please. Why do you take so many shots? I mean, I know you're a helicopter, but good lord, man. Holy. Okay, so let's be very careful here. Let's get on my shield charger, plasma coil, and fire away! It's so great watching them all get shocked at the same time. That's actually one reason why this gun is actually pretty easy to upgrade, even though it's later in the game. Because the later you get in the game, the harder it is to upgrade some of the weapons. So with this, because you can shock multiple enemies at once, it actually ends up being pretty easy to upgrade. Oop. What else? Let me actually, I might as well put like the... I'm not gonna play around with it. I'm not gonna mess around with my settings too much. I know I'm like out of ammo here with a lot of guns, but I don't wanna try to upgrade too many things at once. I wanna focus here on one or two things at once. I may go back actually and get I also have a lot more nanotech than I'm used to having at this point in the game. I think it's because I never get the nanotech upgrades, and in this series I've been getting the nanotech upgrades. Also, my nanotech seems to be upgrading so freaking fast. Like, ridiculously fast, man. Also, how far along is my shield? Yeah, the shield, the thing with the shield is that in order for you to upgrade it, you actually have to take hits or, like, run into enemies. Which actually does damage, by the way. That you can do damage with this weapon by running into them. See, like this. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. That's my song. I don't know where that came from or why I was singing it, but that's my song. Alright, destroy the world. Go this way. What the mother crap? Transformers!
What's so funny?
Nothing, I guess.
prepare to die.
What a great scene. What's so funny? I don't know. Nothing, I guess. Perfect. Okay, so the best way to take out this guy, this is the boss that I was talking about. This boss is actually extremely, extremely tedious. Luckily, there's an easier way to take out this guy than simply using the turrets that are laid out throughout the map. Now, there are, like I said, there are turrets laid out throughout the map that you can go after. But if you just use some of your items, it's actually a bit easier to take him out, because while you're using the turrets, he'll fly around and do stuff like this, so it's actually really hard. Also, the turrets really don't do that much damage. But his patterns, like I said, his patterns change when you get into the turrets. So it becomes kind of a pain in the ass. And he's going to come over here. He's going to try to destroy me at some point, too. So, like, I have to defend myself from his bombs. And I have to also be shooting him to do damage. And then he's going to try and take me out when I've done a lot of damage. See what I mean? And I'm just going to try and fire a bunch of weapons at him, which actually ends up doing a lot more damage in the long run. Which is seriously the best way to do this. So I'm going to start using some of my upgraded weapons, and I'm just going to fire these at him. These don't seem to be doing anything. Like, they don't seem to be shooting at him for some reason. You want to fire at him or no? Stupid turrets. You're not helping anyone. Okay, so let's just switch out to something else. I don't know if the bouncers are actually going to do anything, but I'll try. Yeah, absolutely. The bouncer's a great weapon to use against him. I knew it was. So long as the little bouncy balls hit him. I'll just keep shooting this until something happens. But yeah, no, like, I find this to be the easiest way to defeat him, mostly because, like I said, like, whenever you go into the turrets, it changes his fighting pattern, so he tries to dodge you and crap, instead, like, of just walking back and forth and doing this, spamming him. But like I said, this is a super tedious boss, and really, this is the best way to do it. Because with the turrets, it's so easy to take a lot of damage really quickly, and with this, like, you can just walk back and forth until he's dead. I mean, using a non-upgraded weapon, probably not the best idea, but I'm kind of low on ammo and some stuff. I think there's an ammo box, or an ammo depot somewhere. What am I trying? Vendor, that's the word that I'm looking for, vendor. But yeah, his patterns won't change at all. It just takes a long time to defeat him, and that's really just it. Super tedious. But fun, I mean fun, because I get to just spam him, and that's always fun. When you can exploit a boss like this. I should be using the turrets. In fact, I will use the turrets for, like, the last little bits, I think. Because I will run out of ammo, but... There, I'm out of ammo with that. My mini turret glove doesn't seem to want to do anything. But I've got all of these other guns, right? You know, like, I've got this. This does a ton of damage. And it's got the acid mod, so, like, that's going to do even more damage over time. It actually doesn't do that much damage now that I look at it. It does a bit, though. A chunk. A little tiny chunk. Oh, I missed. I should shoot his thigh. I gotta shoot his thigh. The vaporizer, obviously, is going to be very, very strong. And again, it has the acid mod on it, so it's going to be really good. Do chunks of damage at him. I'll just cycle through all of our weapons. I'll use up the heavy lancer. It's not going to be super helpful, I don't think. No, it's not super helpful, but I might as well use it because I'm going to end up using up all of my ammo anyway, so. This guy has some great dialogue, too, if you listen closely to the background. It's hard for me to hear it right now, and because there's no subtitles, I have no idea what he's saying, but if you listen very closely, you can hear what he's saying. All right, there's all of my heavy lancer. Look at this, he's just consistently shooting at me now at this point. Oh man, I'm taking lots of damage. Probably should start doing something else pretty soon here. But I'm enjoying this too much. The other thing about the turrets too is eventually you run out of turrets because he'll destroy them all. I think they respawn, I could be wrong about that. But man, I hope I don't, like, get shot again. Because he apparently does a lot of damage, and I wasn't aware of that. I mean, look at this. I have literally just walked back and forth this entire battle, and I've almost defeated him already. But I'll jump in a turret here in a minute. Just get rid of all of that ammo. You are an ammo dump, sir. I'm just dumping all of my ammo on you. This is great. Okay, let's figure out where I'm going to go next. I'll just keep going this way. God. I remember having a lot of trouble with this guy as a kid, though, because it takes so long, right? And I would always find myself being killed right at the very, very end. Man, why are you green? That's weird. I don't think I've ever seen you be green before. Including your bombs. Like, you're supposed to be orange. Did I, like, permanently ruin you? Okay, so he's gonna throw a car at me, and this is gonna destroy me unless I destroy the car first. There we go. Oh, that's an insta-death right there. Oh, he's gonna do it again. Oh, God. No, 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 no. I can't do anything about that. Man, he's like... He didn't even give me the chance to use the turret for very long. I guess that's what kind of happens towards the end of it, too. Pain in the ass. Pain in my goddamn ass. That's for sure. Yeah, it's weird. He's permanently green from now on. I think I accidentally acided all over him. I acided all over you. But you can see what I mean. Like, because you can see how much damage the turret's doing. Imagine trying to do the entire boss with just the turrets. You can't. You just can't. But if you have the Zodiac, by the way, this boss is defeated in probably about 5 seconds. Not even. That's how powerful the Zodiac is. Or the Rhino 2. Either or would like take this guy out in 5 seconds. I think the Rhino 2 takes it out even faster. All right, ready? You are so close. I'm just gonna shoot at you. What you gonna do now, son? What you gonna do now? Blow your legs up, that's what.
You okay, Clank? Great. Let's go.
Hello? Aren't you forgetting
Dumbass.
Someone?
Oops. Oh, I meant after we free Angela.
That's funny. Good job, Ratchet.
Thanks.
You're not getting laid that
now,
way, though.
Now, before you run off, take a look at this. I picked it out of Lizard Boy's pocket.
Log entry 4792, returning from Megacorp's distribution center. I'm beginning to suspect that Megacorp has lied to me. The extra-large decorative paperweights being stored there might actually be an enormous supply of protopets, which might explain why the whole facility is guarded by ravenous mutant creatures. Their warehouse ship may hold as many as 10 million crates, and with 100 protopets per crate, that could be as many as, 3.5 zillion protopets.
That's a lot.
Can only mean one thing. Megacorp is up to no good. I will confront them as soon as possible and demand a bigger cut of the action.
Oh, I see.
Are they insane?
Yes, they are very much insane.
Far more danger than I had imagined. Do you suppose, Mr. Fizzwidget?
We've wasted enough time on Fizzwidget already. I swear, that crazy old man is not the same person I used to work for.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You used to work for Megacorp?
Yes.
So did we. What's the difference?
On the protopet?
On fixing the protopet's flaws.
Oh, it's been revealed.
When Fizzwidget suddenly pushed up the release date.
Is it worth disrupting the protopet shipments?
It's a start. But to stop them for good... We're gonna need to break into Megacorp headquarters.
Break
in? Oh, God.
How?
I have an old Megacorp ID on my home planet.
We'll split up then. Clank and I will go to the distribution facility. You go grab the ID.
Oh, my God. Okay, so we're gonna have to pull some crazy Mission Impossible crap on one of the next planets to get into the freaking thing. All right, let's stock it back on an ammo, because we literally used all of our ammo of every gun ever of all time. Yeah, we stocked up a bunch of bolts there, too. Not enough, unfortunately, to get the hover bomb gun. I'm actually gonna save my ammo as well, my bolts for the next armor upgrade as well, because that's gonna become very important, obviously. That it'll match my ship, too, because it's the black and red armor. But yeah, no, I'm excited to progress here, because we're actually, there's only a few planets left The Megacorp distribution facility is the next place that we're going to be going. And I'm excited because this is actually a really cool planet. I like the steampunk atmosphere of this place. But of course, that is going to be it for this episode of Ratchet & Clank Going Commando. Don't forget to give this video a like if you enjoyed it. If you really like this video, consider subscribing to my channel for more content like this. Check out your click on your screen here. Check out any of the other things that I've done this past week. Or click the links in the description if you are on a mobile device, which many of you are. Click that subscribe button in order to be notified of when I upload more Ratchet & Clank if you're interested in that. My name is Josh, and I will see you in the next one.